Hello, everyone. With you, Krivulya Andrew Charlie. In this video, I'll use my drawings to show how neural networks in Phygital Plus can color black and white concepts or generate new ideas. Please, if you want to support this channel, watch the video until the end, because there is important information about this. So, friends, for my experiments I have chosen some of my old drawings, and now I want to color them with Phygital Plus. I am currently experimenting with this platform to find the perfect workflow for our 3D grooming department to create concepts for new characters. To add an image to the interface of your workspace, do the following, right-click, and select Import File from the context menu that appears. Then click the Upload Files button, and select the images you want to upload. So, I'm ready to work on this character. The first thing I want to do is test the Lexica service that is built into Phygital Plus, which allows you to search for similar images. To find similar images, enter two or three words related to your image in the search box, such as cute character or cute creature. As a result, you get images that match your keywords, and you can choose what you like. Once you click on an image, the service offers you similar images and a prompt for that image. For example, I really like this picture, so I click on it. Now, I use the suggested prompt associated with this image and copy it by pressing CTRL+C. Then, I right-click and choose Transform Image and CTRL+NAT. After performing these actions, a special node will appear with instructions on how to use it. I recommend reading it to understand which modes can be applied to your work and what results they produce. I will demonstrate the modes I use to transform my art. So, for the node to start processing your image, it must be plugged into a slot called Start Image. Next, in the text prompt box, paste the description you copied from Lexica. Then go down, open the Settings tab, and here we only need the type option where we leave head for this node. Then copy this node using the CTRL+C, CTRL+V shortcut. Then we connect our image to the new node and select the depth mode. Repeat this action twice, selecting Scribble and Edge modes for new nodes, and don't forget to connect our image. Now, so that the nodes do not take up much space, we can collapse all the settings. Great, now I'm going to find the right prompt for this character. I'm going to move this image to a slightly different location for convenience. Now, I will create a prompt for this image using the special Describe Image node. While the prompt is being generated, we move on to the next image, but first we run the previous processes for the first image. For this image, I choose ChatGPT, which is also part of the Phygital Plus ecosystem, in order to have a prompt. I'll write, "Think of a prompt for a picture of a tree floating on an island." Now that you don't have to press the play button next to the text, let's copy what we have. For more convenience, I will also move this image to the right. Then, I copy the generation node from the first picture, connect the new image, and insert the new prompt. It is most often recommended to use the Scribble mode for this type of image, but since I like to experiment, we will also try to use the same modes as for the first art. So we copy the node for times, select the same modes as for the first image, and start the rendering process. Okay, while these images are rendering, we can start working with the sample for the second image, since it is already ready. Okay, for convenience I will move this node to this area. I am going to copy the same generator for this node as well. Since I need to color this image, I will modify the resulting prompt a bit, and add keywords related to color rendering. Now, we connect the node with the prompt to the text prompt node, and the image to the start image node. Then, we repeat the same operations with the nodes as for the previous images. Okay, so while the rendering is going on, we are going to work with these two images. So, I want to create stylized grass stones based on my drawing. I go into Lexica and type in keywords to select an image I like and get the right prompt for it. Then, as usual, I click on my favorite image to get various options and prompts. I really like this picture, so I am going to copy its prompt and use it for my generations to come. Now, using the copied prompt for this new image, I repeat the same operations I did for the previous images. While the rendering is going on, I continue to work with this image. As usual, I have a look in Lexica for the right prompt for this image. I think this prompt is perfect for my task. I will copy it and repeat all the same steps with nodes and settings as before. The stones are already rendered in the process of adjusting all these parameters. Let's take a look at what that looks like and see what we've got. An error occurred in the third node, possibly due to the non-standard size of the image. In this case, it is recommended to compress the image to a more standard size. Okay, let's see what happened to the first image. Let's open it and see the results of the rendering. Let's take a look at what we have with the depth map. As you can see, this map uses the depth information of the image and tries to create a creature based on that information. Let's see what kind of shape and structure we get as a result. Let's take a look at the result of the Scribble mode. This mode allows you to create unique and interesting elements and details with freehand drawing and strokes. That's right, Scribble mode tries to recreate the scribbles of your concept and creates a three-dimensional image based on them. It uses information about the strokes and their placement to give the image volume and texture. But I want to make the final image more dependent on the concept, so I reduce the value of denoising strength to 0.3. Now, let's take a look at the result in the edge mode and see what happens. The result in Scribble mode, with a strength of 0.5, has already been rendered, so let's take a look and see what we get. So, of all the modes applied to the knives, I only like the result with the depth mode, so I decided to delete the other results and keep only this one. Now, I want to modify the prompt using the Describe Image node to describe an already finished image. Okay, while the prompt is being prepared, we have a look at the other concept, in the style of InkPunk. Of course, I won't take the time to go through all the styles at this point, but I want to see what Edge of Realism will look like. I think this turned out to be impressive. I also tried another new model, and you can see the result on the cover. In addition, I decided to perform another experiment by adding some details to the image and applying similar operations to it. The result was the following. By the way, the concept of the knife is also finished. You'll recall that I used the depth mode and set the denoising strength value to 0.5 tenths. The last thing I want to show you is the ability to upscale the selected image we got as a result of rendering. For example, if I want to upscale a second image, I simply move the mouse over it and click the 2x icon. We can see that an upscale node is added for the second slot where this image is located. The result is this image. We can upscale it again if needed. The result is an image with a resolution of 2K. If you like this video, don't forget to write about it in the comments, put a like and subscribe to the channel. And please watch this video until the end. Friends, if you need quality 3D hairstyle references, go to the 3D.sk website. The site has two categories, groom 3D scans and groom photos. There aren't many scans on the site, but there are enough hair photos to start making something for your character already. Just a reminder that you can become a channel sponsor and get a voiceover in another language, a collection of my references, and a 100% discount on all my assets. Just click the join button to do it. If this is your first time on this channel, then here you can learn all the tricks and secrets of 3D grooming in Ornatrix. Also, get your questions answered and get inspired by references from the games. Subscribe and write in the comments how long you do 3D and why you chose this field, what influenced this. If you like what I do, I would be very grateful for any donation to Donatello at the link in the description and channel header. Buying my models on CG Trader or ArtStation, as well as the purchase of any of the plugins at the links in the attached commentary. What's in it for you? It's very simple. If enough money is collected per month, I will be able to devote my full time to creating lessons for you, not 3 hours a day, which, as you have already noticed, not enough for the fast release of new episodes. Also, don't forget to check out the YouTube community as I share there all kinds of news, uploading answers to questions, talking about the time spent time on lessons, and so on. And, of course, don't forget about my Instagram, where I upload all my work and work in progress.